Hey, this is Jimmy Broadfield. Join me every Thursday at 1 p.m. for Broadfield Live, Liquid Lunch and Learn. Today we have a special guest joining us, Don Rigo from Bird Dog. And before we get into the show, we do like to introduce a nice liquid lunch that we have for the day. But today is a really special show because it is our first live broadcast going to LinkedIn Live. So we apologize for being a minute or two tardy. It is because we are trying out this new technology. We are broadcasting live to LinkedIn right now. And let's crack open the beer. So right now I have a Rahr & Sons Ugly Pug Black Lager, which was kindly sent to me by our workflow sales guy, Glenn, who's in Texas, where this is brewed. And as you can see from the pour, it is most definitely a black lager. Don, I know you're a big fan of some drinks, so what do you have on the show for us today?
Well, I know Glenn's got high standards, so hopefully that sounds, I hope it tastes as good as it sounds. I'm in Kentucky, so I've brought bourbon naturally, and today I'm having Old Forester, and I'm not drinking it straight because I'm a little hungover. It's the day after St. Patrick's Day, so I'm gonna be mixing that with a little bit of cola, and geez, man, 1 o'clock in the afternoon, you got me. Maybe that's exactly what I needed. It was a little hair of the dog.
Absolutely. So, Don, I have to ask, what exactly happens in Kentucky on St. Patrick's Day? Do you still drink bourbons or do you go for the Irish whiskey?
Well, you know, it's funny. Since the lockdown started, you know, everybody's just been, there's been more bourbon sold in Kentucky in the last year, I think I read recently, than have been sold in almost like 2 years previous. And in fact, there's more barrels of bourbon and aging in Kentucky than there are people living in Kentucky. I didn't go anywhere and I didn't notice what anybody was drinking, but it's pretty much it's a bourbon kind of a place.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, Don, I didn't invite you on the show to sell bourbon. I invited you on the show to sell Bird Dog. And really specifically, what I wanted to focus on today is the Bird Dog PTZ camera family, which has grown quite a bit since we first launched some of these PTZ cameras. And what I want to point out to our dealers, with your help, of course, is that these Bird Dog cameras really have a solution that fits in to every different workflow along the way. So, Don, do me a favor and just quickly run through the overview of the different camera models that are available in the family.
Yeah, sure. Happy to do that. Yeah, Bird Dog, we make cameras, we make converters, and we have software, but I like to think of us as a live presence company. You know, we make tools that make live presence available to people in any market. So as you say, which camera models do we have? I'd like to put that in the context of how are people using NDI, the internet, and cameras to accomplish some kind of live presence. Yep. So we have it from an entry-level standpoint, price point, all the way up to professional level. And all of our cameras are full NDI with our own custom silicon NDI chip. So with all of that said, I guess I'll start at the bottom and go on up. But the first camera in our model is the P100. And the P100 is an amazing value for what bang for your buck, I guess you could say.
Yep, absolutely.
You know, it comes in at $1,599 MSRP, but it's a full NDI camera. It's got a 10x optical zoom, gives you a range of aperture control from f-stop 1.6 up. It's got full bandwidth NDI. It's got quad outputs, right? So we're talking HDMI, SDI, NDI, and USB. Right. So, I mean, it's incredibly versatile camera. And for that price point, you know, we'll take the Pepsi challenge with any camera out there in the market.
Yep.
And this one's tough to beat.
Absolutely. And then what I like, too, is from the P100, you go from that affordability and flexibility and versatility to the P200, which is going to give you that Sony CMOS sensor and really the optics and the quality to fit into some of those HD broadcast productions. And then from there, you have the 4K camera line with the P400 and the P4K. And then, and we'll go into all of these models a little bit more specifically throughout the show. But then, Don, you also have the A200 and 300, which are really kind of fitting into a unique niche in the marketplace, being the all-weather models, which the A-series bring to the table.
Yeah.
Don, we can send out the dispatch sheets to all of our dealers, and hopefully a lot of our dealers are familiar with some of these different bird dog models. What I really wanted you to talk about today are some of the recent wins and success stories of where we're seeing these cameras installed. Starting with what you and I talked about before the show, the P100. The P100 is a true testament to the versatility and the flexibility of the camera, is how often you're seeing these used, most recently in the NBA bubble and with the NBA teams. Don, tell us a little bit about that.
Well, the NBA part was really exciting to us. And so we live in good times. You know, there are great tools from a lot of different manufacturers, and NDI has solved problems that we've been kind of waiting for this technology, I think, for decades, you know, 20-something years now. And the ability to send, you know, these four things over one wire and not have to do special cable runs and use your existing LAN architecture. And, you know, the promise of NDI is always something that everyone was looking forward to. So now that we have NDI, okay, what are your options? Well, you know, there are options out there, and we're really very fortunate to have started with NewTek, who developed the NDI protocol years ago to develop our custom chip. So once we have really established ourselves as the very first and kind of leading manufacturer of NDI, dedicated NDI cameras, we wanted to have a camera for every kind of a market. Now, the P100 was one of one of many different kind of PTZ choices that the NBA had available to them.
Yeah.
And I think that they chose us for some particular, you know, for some specific reasons. But the NBA is one example that is you know, it almost caused this a shortage. I don't really want to say that, you know, we have supply issues, because we don't. But at one point, every single team was vying for the available inventory that was in landed inventory in North America for a couple of weeks there, as you guys remember.
Don, I gotta tell you, when you get the technical director for a league like the NBA, send out an email to 30 plus teams and say, you need to buy three of these cameras, set them up in your stadium, set them up in your bubble, set them up for your social media and for your interview. Everybody receiving that email is now dialing the phone. We've had dealers that had relationships with the Chicago Bulls and the Atlanta Hawks, and now all of a sudden, they're being told, I need three of this, two of that, one of those, and by the way, I need it here tomorrow, you know?
Yeah, I know. It was wild, man. It really was wild. I mean, it was a real fire drill there, you know, as we were taking a lot of inbound. But, you know, that's a really exciting kind of a customer, but we have customers of every kind of possible content you can imagine. I mean, everything from an eye doctor that was doing service work for mission work or something in other countries, telemedicine.
Yeah.
I was involved in a demo yesterday in Columbus that also involved telemedicine. You know, we've got everything from schools, K-12 education.
Yeah. And that's one of the things. That's one of the things I wanted to point out too, because, you know, as good of a win as the NBA opportunity is, the nice thing about the P100 camera is it gives you the flexibility of the outputs, including live video over the USB, which makes it the perfect upgradable camera to Zoom or Microsoft Teams. So now when you're working with education or house of worship, where they're trying to get the speaker to have the freedom to move about the classroom or the lecture hall, but have the camera be able to follow their movements and take advantage of moving from the blackboard to the whiteboard or to other presentation materials, the P100 is a good way to upgrade that optical quality and get the PTZ capabilities.
Yeah, very well said, man. I think that the combination of what NDI brings to the table, and then also what's good and special about our camera, made it the right camera at the right time. And as far as the NDI part, so yeah, the P100 can deliver everything you need for your production. You got video, audio, headset, line in, control, tally, Then again, our own special sauce, which I always ring the bell.
Yep.
When we say special sauce with Broadfield folks. Is okay. So we have an optical zoom. Okay, so this is different than a digital zoom, and
sure.
So it allows you to drop this camera into different kinds of rooms, environments, and be able to get shots at different angles and close up.
And that's a perfect segue down into the P200, which I'm just going to skip ahead to that for just a moment. One of the big advantages in where we see the P200 being spec'd into some of these installations is for customers who need that larger lens, the larger optical zoom capability, the win that we have here with the Philadelphia Eagles.
Right. Yeah. The P200 takes that. We were just talking about the optical zoom. So the P100, the little brother, is 10x.
Yep.
P200, the big brother, is 30x. Okay, so yeah, now we're talking about much larger venues, and that's the P200 has really been kind of our bread and butter camera. It's our real workhorse.
Yep.
We sell it in a bundle where you buy three and you get the keyboard for free, which seems three is sort of the magic number from Schoolhouse Rock, and but also for House of Worship, and
yep.
for schools, and for a room of a particular size, or an auditorium or a venue of a particular size, three is kind of a number.
Sure.
And that bundle, as you well know, has been extremely successful. But the P200, and just to talk a little bit about the technical differences, now we're talking about a Sony CMOS backlit sensor, Sony image module, super fast focus capability. That's a camera that, hey, listen, I'm never ever going to say anything or to try to knock our competition, but I will say this. I don't see anybody else taking selfies with our competitors' cameras and posting them online.
Right.
But we have customers that take selfies of themselves with their P200 camera and put it online. And this is not something we started. This is something that's kind of somehow started itself.
Absolutely.
We had a gallery of kind of like very happy users of the Bird Dog family.
And one of the reasons I wanted to do the show today is, in addition to talking about the cameras themselves and the hardware and how they fit into the different installations, Bird Dog is also upping the technical capabilities of these cameras by developing software and apps that even get more capabilities and more control of the camera itself. One of the slides that I glanced past that I definitely wanted to go back to was this one, talking about the video that Dan Mile released earlier this week, showing your new cam control software with the P100. Don, do you want to give us a quick overview of cam control?
Yeah, cam control integration brings all sort of professional level controls into an application. You can monitor multiple cameras simultaneously. You can adjust settings, fine detail. It's got a nice sort of touch-friendly interface. As you say, you can field upgrade these cameras via firmware updates. We just recently introduced color matrix,
yep.
Cam control integration. So yeah.
And I know you were talking about the P200 bundle, and one of the great things about the cam control is when you're using multiple cameras in a church or a school auditorium, that you can use that app and go into your camera settings and color match them to get the best image quality possible from all of the cameras in a multi-camera environment.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what's so cool about it. You know, this is what NDI was, we all hoped would make possible.
Absolutely, making all of that possible with nothing but one cable delivering the video, the power, and the control all over that single cat set. It definitely is a huge, huge advantage.
It's been a light bulb moment for a lot of people. And I've known you for over 20 years, and it's funny because I look at it like an esports kind of a customer. They just assume that we're talking about a network platform or deployment. So NDI has just arrived into this universe at just the right time as well, because
sure.
from the pandemic to OTT kind of video streaming.
Yep.
This is a network world. This is not a broadcasting cabling kind of gig.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And that's one note that I know Glenn would appreciate me sharing with everyone. And since he sent the beer today, I definitely have to give the shout out. When you're speccing out multiple cameras in an install, make sure that you are working with your customers on the network switch and the PoE needs for the cameras. The P100 and 200, for example, require the PoE plus protocol, whereas when we get into the 400 and the 4K camera, these are PoE plus. So they're going to suck that power from the network switch, and your network switch does have to be able to deliver the correct power protocol over Ethernet in order to power these cameras for that one cable solution that we talked about. Don, before we get into the 4K cameras, I wanted to talk to you a little bit about the all-weather cameras, the A200 and the A300. I know that I've seen some images posted by Eamon showing off the A200 outside of the Capitol building and outside of the White House, and the A300 is starting to be implemented now into stadiums. Now, if we can only get people and sports into these stadiums with them, we'll have a lot of great stuff to show off there. But are there any specific wins or case studies or installs that you know that are happening now on these cameras that we can share with our dealers today?
Yeah, and these cameras were, when I joined the company, these were the ones that were most interesting to me because they really are kind of, it's a unique animal. Let's just start with the A300 for a minute. It looks like it's got two lenses on it.
Yeah,
it doesn't. You know, one of those is a laser that's for fast focus, and it doesn't have a windshield wiper on it. The reason it doesn't is because it's got a gas-filled chamber, which keeps it from fogging. There was a video that one of the co-founders, Eamon Drew, had put, I think, from a trade show in Europe someplace one time, where they were literally like showing its durability by beating on it with a baseball bat. and the thing is built, okay? I mean, it's built, and there's a specification for hurricane ratings.
Yeah,
I forget what it's called, IP67 or 68 or something like that.
The IP67 is the waterproof rating, but there is a wind rating that is eligible up to a Category 4 hurricane, which in itself is unbelievable.
Yeah, thanks for helping me remember what was the rating part of that.
But, I'm more than just a pretty face here, Don.
Well, we know where these are being used, in some cases, it's such a specific kind of a customer that you can't write it up as much of a case story. Because for instance, one of my customers is Bird Dog's customers.
Yep.
Is a missile base in Alabama. So, I mean, I guess that's all I could say about it.
Right.
But they need to be able to have hardened, tough-built, solutions that
sure.
can stand up to the whatever is the situation of abuse to the housing.
Yep.
And again, rocket launches. We've been able to see video. We know that's our camera for rocket launches and landings. But for sporting, for sure, the A200 is a $5,200 tough built outdoor NDI camera that could go onto cruise ships, that could go into sport stadiums from high school level, college level, hockey arenas to baseball stadiums to, hey, I'm in Kentucky, so horse racing.
Yep.
I learned something interesting. Horses, prize-winning horses, are sold and auctioned around the world by the means of a video live auction. So these things go in stables, okay?
There you go.
If you need an outdoor NDI camera that has got specs that go toe-to-toe with anything in the world, and it's tough built and you can count on it in all conditions,
yep.
Make sure you look at Bird Dog A-Series. So people ask us about the P-Series and the A-Series naming convention we've got. A just means all weather. P means production.
Absolutely. And then the latest update in the P family is, of course, the P400 and the P4K. Now, these are both 4K cameras. The P400 comes in at $39.95 MSRP, and the P4K comes in at $79.95. Obviously, there's a difference in the price point, and there's a difference in the cameras. Don, can you give us a quick overview of the differences between the P400 and the P4K?
Yeah, absolutely. We'll start with the P400. The P400 is a 10-bit 4K NDI camera. So in some ways, I like to think of it myself as the 4K version of the P200 that we talked about before, right? Except that one of the major differences is really the 10-bit 4K. So anybody can look at the specs online and go through a matrix that we've got and understand the differences as you step up through the line. But think of the P400 as the big brother to the P200 10-bit 4K. Okay. Now the P4K, which is our top of the line camera, which comes in at $79.95. You would think that would be a camera that is only for a particular type of customer. So from a sales perspective, we might sell fewer of those than we would of an entry-level camera. Turns out people are scooping up the P4K and everything from, professional sports, NFL. I don't know that it's permitted to start calling out some of the customers that we have on this, but let's just say that, Super Bowl-level network-level coverage involved those cameras. And the P4K is really one of a kind because it's got the Sony 1-inch sensor.
Yep.
The Sony X, I think it's called the XMR CMOS backlit sensor, 14.4 million effective pixels, and an NDI built.
Yep.
Motorized housing that is. That Bird Dog is famous for is kind of an industry first and an industry favorite.
Yeah, and Don, I think we said earlier, between the P100 to the P200, the P100, even though it's the most affordable base model, is really flexible and versatile to be installed in a lot of applications. But when you need to make the jump up for optical image needs, that's where the value comes in the P200, and that's how you would justify the additional expense. Now, while the P400 is the 4K version of the P200, there is still yet another level jump where the P4K now allows you to make the maximum use of that 4K imagery to get your larger color depth, your Sony 1-inch sensor. So it's really an optical image difference when you need to sell the best of the best 4K image quality. The P400 is not a sacrifice by any means, but the 4K is the above and beyond.
Yeah, that's very well put. And it's funny, we started our conversation about talking about what kind of customers you've got and what do they need and what are their where was their location and what's the content, and we're kind of wrapping up the conversation in the same way. In that, if you need, for instance, adaptable light conditions are going to be changing, maybe you're set up for a shot in a hotel lobby at noon, but at 4 p.m the light's different and it's changed. There's a camera and a sensor and a capability across our line for all of this. There's been some examples in our Bird Dog user group on Facebook recently of just dropping in cameras and places on stages, right? For musical performances, where there's constant lighting changes, low light, no light, even direct spotlight camera facing light, and these cameras just sort of perform beyond people's expectations, and you tell me.
And Don, I think that's the perfect segue though into the P200 bundle. I think one of the reasons why the P200 bundle with the three cameras and the PTZ controller is so popular is for the exact conditions you just described. If you're selling a PTZ camera system into house of worship or a staging environment where those lights are constantly changing. And they might even have low light conditions or just weird lighting coming in through stained glass windows. These are very difficult places to get a good image quality. You put in three of the P200 cameras, you get the free controller, and that's why this bundle, which actually started out last May, has been brought back and extended and is now part of our offerings that our dealers can go out there and put together some really nice competitive quotes.
Yeah, I remember we called it March Madness, and and here we are back in March again. Yeah, that bundle never went away because we had so many requests constantly saying, well, you know, I just got my budget approved, but, you know, it's going to be after, you know, the promo. It's a permanent promo as far as we're concerned. But, yeah, thanks for pointing that out. I mean, again, there's a lot of good choices in technology out there these days, and you know, look through everything that's available. And you know, again, I think that people have spoken when it comes to the love of our cameras that's developed among our our user family, taking pictures and sharing selfies with the cameras is, you know, I just don't see it with other brands. So I have to give the credit to the engineers in Australia that have created the kind of the very best NDI, full NDI, PTZ cameras available anywhere in the world. And, you know, take it from me or test it out yourself. You'll be happy with the choice that you make when you pick up one of our cameras.
And you know, Don, I really appreciate you coming on. Broadfield has a great relationship with Bird Dog from shipping day one. And we are super excited to see the product offerings grow and to see the product line grow, not only from these PTZ cameras and controllers, but with the new Flex NDI converters and the NDI 4K converters and just everything else across the entire NDI product line. I want to let our dealers know that I have the cam control video from Dan that we will share with today's webinar. I also have some of the different case studies and images that we spoke about. If there's anything that Don and I can do to help you close some of these additional sales, to help sell this P200 bundle out into the marketplace, or to work with you or your customers to find the right camera that fits into their needs, definitely reach out to Broadfield at 800-634-5178. All of our Broadfield salespeople are fully trained and versed on the Bird Dog product line. And if necessary, if we really have to, we can bring Don in to help us as well.
Yeah, well, good luck finding me. hey, man, before we wrap up, there's something I'm really proud of that I want to show you, Jim. Because
what's that?
Also, thank you for the nice comments about working with us from the get-go here with Bird Dog, because you guys have been instrumental and you've invested in folks like Glenn works and workflow specialists to really help dealers, you know, talk through with their customer. NDI is kind of new to everybody. So you guys have taken the time and the money and to invest in the in-house intelligence and expertise. So that's wonderful. And so I wanted to do something for you and you too, Jim, because we've been friends and we've known each other for a very long time. And I hope you can see this on camera.
But,
I'll have to send you a picture.
I just see that's Woodford Reserve right there.
Yeah, but what's special about it is that I had a special select reserve numbered bottle made with your name on it.
Oh, lovely. Don, thank you.
And that's what it says right here. And it's a numbered bottle for you that I got from the distillery, which is just maybe like less than an hour's drive from me. And I'm able to get a certain amount of those a year. And this one's yours, bud.
Thank you, Don. I really appreciate that. I am a big fan of Woodford Reserve. And I promise you that will be well appreciated and enjoyed. I will have that in the back of my office next time you're up here in New York to visit.
Yeah, cool. I went up and swiped the beer like I did the last time.
Hey, that's why we're here, buddy. Thank you so much for joining us today. Remember, join Broadfield every Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern time, 1 p.m., 1 p.m. I don't even know what time of day it is anymore. Join us every Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern time, now live every week on LinkedIn Live. Until next week, cheers.
Cheers, Ed.
Join us every Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern Time for another Broadfield Liquid Lunch and Learn live webinar. Next week, we're excited to be joined by Secure Data to introduce their expanded product line. Tune in at news.broadfield.com/live. Broadfield Distributing is a value-added distributor of live production, streaming, video editing, and storage products. We only sell to resellers. We are always looking for new dealers. So call us at 1-800-634-5178 or email sales@broadfield.com. You'll like doing business with Broadfield because we make it easy to do business.